Hi, I'm Lisa Ramsey, the owner and founder of Medi-Cal Consulting Services. I started this company almost 17 years ago with the philosophy of providing accurate and honest information to help you make informed decisions. I hope this video helps you understand Medi-Cal a little bit better. It can be so confusing and overwhelming. What is Medi-Cal? Basically, it's medical insurance to pay for physician visits, hospital stays, pharmacy bills, medical equipment, and so much more. If you have medical insurance in place already, Medi-Cal will not interfere with that. Your current insurance benefits will not be affected. So if you have insurance, Medi-Cal will become your secondary insurance. As your secondary insurance, Medi-Cal can pay your co-payments for physician visits, prescriptions, and medical equipment. Can also pay for incontinence supplies, transportation, and even dental visits. Medi-Cal also pays for long-term care. Long-term care can be provided in a number of ways. Maybe at home with in-home supportive services, through adult daycare, in a board and care, assisted living community with the assisted living waiver program, or in a nursing home. While you're living in a private home, in-home supportive services can provide care for up to 283 hours a month. That's like 9 hours a day, 7 days a week. You get to decide who the caregiver will be. Maybe a family member, a friend, a neighbor. And you get to set the work schedule. For example, maybe you only want those hours Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, because those are going to be your shower days, your doctor appointment days, or your shopping days. Or you may want to spread them evenly across the month, so every day someone is coming in to check on you. Medi-Cal pays for adult daycare. This benefit can be combined with your IHSS hours. You can get picked up, taken to the center. This is great for socialization. There are exercise programs and health monitoring. They provide snacks and meals throughout the day, and the care is provided by professionals. The Assisted Living Waiver Program can help with the expense of assisted living and board and care. Unfortunately, due to the limited participation by both county and provider, the wait list is approximately 12 to 18 months. So if this is a program you're interested in, it's really important that you get Medi-Cal eligibility as quickly as possible so you can be placed on the wait list. Keep in mind that there are additional requirements both clinically and financially for this program, and priority is given for those residing in a nursing home. Speaking of a nursing home, a skilled nursing facility, rehab center, post-acute center, they're all one and the same. It's just how they market themselves. With your typical insurance, like Medicare or Medicare Advantage plan, they limit their coverage to a maximum of 100 days, which includes co-payments. And there are very specific requirements in order to receive those 100 days. So most people normally don't qualify for 100 days. The average stay is about 28 days. Medi-Cal does not have a maximum time limit, nor are you required to stay a certain length of time. So if you go into a rehab center after a slip and fall or illness and your Medicare comes to an end, you can stay an additional period of time to recover with your Medi-Cal benefit. Maybe you just need a couple extra weeks to gain some extra strength, or this may be the level of care you'll need for the remainder of your life. The important thing to know is Medi-Cal can pay for that. Almost all skilled facilities accept Medi-Cal, and we can help you determine which facilities accept Medi-Cal in your area. The Medicare Premium Payment Program, or Medicare Buy-In, allows Medi-Cal to pay Medicare Part A and or Medicare Part B premiums for Medi-Cal beneficiaries and others who qualify for Medi-Cal under special programs, allowing Medi-Cal to defer medical costs to Medicare where appropriate. The Medicare Premium Program payment and the Medicare Part D State Contribution Payment Program helps to ensure that Medi-Cal is the payer of last resort. If you qualify for any of these special contribution payment programs, you will see the increase in your Social Security check about 3 months following your approval for Medi-Cal. By 2024, immigration status will no longer prevent anyone in California from receiving Medi-Cal benefits, regardless of their age. In California, we have a look-back period. It's 30 months. That's 2.5 years. If any has been gifted, traded, sold, closed out, transferred, Medi-Cal wants to know the dirty details. What was given? When was it given? In what manner was it given? This does not mean that you can't have gifted or sold anything. Medi-Cal is merely assessing whether you followed the Medi-Cal regulations. During our free assessment, we'll review all of your assets to determine current eligibility and we'll strategize for potential barriers. We can discuss any transfers or gifting concerns. We'll also help you understand how Medi-Cal can benefit you now in your current situation, as well as when your care needs change. This is really important as you plan for your future needs. There's no income limit for a disabled applicant or an applicant over the age of 65, basically anyone who's on Medicare. Income is only used to determine your share of cost. So what is a share of cost? Basically, your share of cost is similar to a monthly deductible. You would be responsible for any medical bills up to your share of cost. This is not a monthly premium. It's not owed if there aren't any services provided that month. Share of cost is paid directly to the provider, and it cannot be prorated. If you have a high share of cost or deductible, you may not see much of a benefit from your Medi-Cal. Just like if you have car insurance with a $1,000 deductible. If you crack your windshield, you might pay $500 to $600 out of your pocket. And even though you have insurance, it didn't really do much for you. With a high share of cost, it's kind of the same. We can calculate your estimated share of cost and discuss ways to eliminate that high share of cost and allow you to take full advantage of the benefits. And some programs require you to have a zero share of cost in order to participate. A typical Medi-Cal application for a married couple living at home will combine their assets and income, which can limit their ability to receive benefits. A high share of cost is common in these applications. The Home and Community-Based Services Waiver is available for married applicants, which allows Medi-Cal benefits for only one spouse, if that's all that's needed. This waiver can help you access programs like IHSS and keep your spouse at home versus going into a nursing home. Let's talk about estate recovery. California does participate in the estate recovery program through Medi-Cal. So at the time of the beneficiary's death, Medi-Cal will seek payment from the estate of the deceased for services provided. The estate recovery takes place after the death of the beneficiary and their spouse. Thanks to Senate Bill 833, the recovery process is now limited to only estates that go into probate. So no probate, no estate recovery. Your home and assets can be safeguarded any time prior to the death of the beneficiary and spouse. If nothing was done to avoid probate, a hardship waiver is available for families to request after the death of the beneficiary, if needed. Medi-Cal Consulting Services is your best option in getting accurate and honest information. We're the go-to resource in the industry because we have an amazing team of Medi-Cal experts. And like myself, some of them are former Medi-Cal eligibility workers. There are other professionals offering Medi-Cal advice, typically attorneys, financial advisors, care coordinators, and sometimes Good Samaritans. These other Medi-Cal advisors often only use one method to help you qualify. It's all they know. Most of them don't understand all the complicated programs and various other ways to help you qualify. Nor do they know ways to utilize options in helping you maximize your benefits. We here at Medi-Cal Consulting Services will guarantee your results in writing, and we provide ongoing case management support. Your questions don't stop once you get approved. Thank you for your time today. I hope this video really helped you. Please like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and visit our website for other frequently asked questions.